guys, Queen V here for Becoming Beauty Salon. So due to the enormous amount of misinformation out there, I have decided to do a 5-part series on the matters of growing healthy hair. In this video, I'm going to give tried and true hair growth facts. I'm going to bust hair growth myths. I'm also going to let you know what the experts are saying about hair growth remedies and how to recognize the difference between normal shedding versus thinning and breakage. I will also address the hype around Hairfinity, Biotin, and Monistat. Yes, Monistat. People are using that in their hair. I'm also going to give you the testimony of those who are using these products in their hair. Then I'm going to give my perspective about if everyone can grow long hair. Alright, disclaimer. My only desire is to spread clarity where there's a bit of misunderstanding. And with any information, it's your choice whether you will receive it or not. But I am a licensed professional since 1999, but because I don't know everything and there's always room for improvement, your kind-hearted suggestions are always welcome here. So before I begin, I would like to send a shout out to two of my favorite clients, Miss Margaret Moore and her daughter, Christina Moore, who gifted me these beautiful earrings. Thank y'all so much. I'd also like to give a shout out to Sydney Lofton, owner of Imagine Cosmetics, who gifted me this beautiful lip gloss. It's Pink Kisses, and I love it. Thank you so much. If you'd like to see her full line, I'll post the link below this video. So, the question is, true or false? Everyone can grow long hair. So before I share my perspective, I would like to explain the hair growth cycle. So let me drop some hair science on you. The hair growth cycle has 3 phases. The first phase, anagen, this is the growing or active phase that 90% of your hair is in. An average growth rate is about 1/4 of an inch to a 1/2 inch per month, which averages to about 6 inches per year. An average growth span is between 2 to 6 years, which is determined by genetics. The second phase is catagen. This is the transitional phase when growth stops and the strand of hair is being prepared to be dropped, which lasts for about 2 to 3 weeks. The third is telogen. This is the resting phase when the follicle refrains from producing another strand of hair and drops the previous one. This lasts for about 100 days before the cycle begins over again. This is what keeps our hair rejuvenated and why we see hair falling into the sink or shower or the hair in your brush, what we call shedding. The average rate of shedding is normally about 20 to 100 hairs a day. It's different for everyone. It just depends on your genetics. The amount you see in your brush daily should be roughly the same, with the exception of coming out of protective styles such as braids, twists, bantu knots, anything that has put your hair up for an extended amount of time. I go further into this in a video I did previously, and I also inform you how to properly remove braids. So if you're interested, take a look. So don't let shedding disturb your peace unless there's a noticeable change in thickness. And if you're unsure, compare your older pictures to pictures of your hair now. And if you are experiencing some thinning, you must determine if it's excessive shedding or breakage, because broken hair and shedding both leave the hair looking thin. So the way that you can tell is, shed hair that has fallen from a scalp, you'll notice that it will have like a small white bulb on the beginning of the hair. And excessive shedding will cause the scalp to be more visible. Fallen broken pieces are short and not a full strand of hair. Excessive breakage is going to leave small to large patches of hair, which may be visible mid-shaft or very close to your scalp, just depending on where the damage occurred. So it's common to mistake broken hair for new hair. So let me explain how you can tell the difference. Broken hair is always going to run in packs. You're always going to see a group of broken hair together. While new hair that is in the beginning anagen phase, it runs solo. It's evenly distributed throughout your scalp. They're those short hairs that you see standing up on end when you straighten your hair. So there could be a number of reasons why you're experiencing breakage or thinning, which I will discuss in part 4, where I name 10 things that keep your hair from growing to its full potential. I think it's great how everyone is beginning to grasp that healthy hair starts from the inside out. So hair vitamins have become a big trend now. Another trend that is going on now, folks are using creams that were meant for fungal infections, such as Monistat, in their hair for hair growth. But my question is, if genetics determines our growth rate and span, how are so many people claiming that these products actually grew their hair longer and faster? So here's what I found. So Hairfinity is one of the popular hair vitamins that people are swearing by right now. It contains two major ingredients in very high quantities, which are MSM and biotin, which claim to increase the hair growth rate and strength. The side effects are headache, excessive hair shedding, and acne. Here's what Dr. Oz has to say about hair vitamins.
And finally, vitamin supplements.
Vitamin supplements are effective in providing basic health, but I don't think we can correlate vitamins across the board with health. Now, if you're not getting your omega-3s or your biotins, then you're going to have to take it through a supplement. But in general, you should get the hair you want by avoiding injuring it and eating the foods that allow your body to naturally craft what you want.
I also would like to share some testimonials, but I only use those with accurate and detailed measurements with specific dates and pictures. Here's Lexi's experience with Hairfinity. I posted her link to the full video below.
And my hair at the end of January. Big difference, right? My hair, as you can see, at the end of January was longer, but it was considerably thinner than it was when I was off those pills for 4 months.
Biotin aids with fatty acid production, metabolism, and cell growth. It claims to increase the hair and nail growth rate and strength. When taken in excess, the side effects are headaches, excessive shedding, and acne. Forgive me if I murder this name, but I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It could be Fume or Fume. From the International Journal of Toxicology, says that most people will not have a biotin deficiency. Most receive all of this vitamin through diet. A typical diet provides between 100 to 300 micrograms of biotin a day, much more than the 30 needed. If you're taking biotin, you're actually getting 100 times more than what you really need per day. And actually, a multivitamin will provide the recommended daily dose.
Basically, I've been having random pimples pop up. A lot of people who took the higher dosages, like I'm taking, they saw really, really bad breakouts.
The other ingredient, MSM, in Hairfinity, which stands for, all right, forgive me, I'm about to merge this word too. Methyl sulfony methane. I don't know. Some are actually choosing to purchase this ingredient alone instead of purchasing Hairfinity or another hair vitamin that has it in high quantities. It's actually a natural ingredient, sulfur, one of the principal building blocks of hair, nails, bones, and cartilage. When taken in excess, some of the side effects are nausea, diarrhea, kidney problems, bloating, fatigue, itching, headaches, insomnia, and worsening of allergy symptoms. So Dr. Phoenix says that the cooking process does leach some MSM from the food, so a supplement wouldn't hurt. It's found in some foods like milk, onions, seafood, garlic, and green veggies.
I emptied these 3 bottles. Took these now for 5 months. When it comes to growth, no. There is nothing spectacular. My hair just grew the same as they would grow on a regular base. So there was no 2 inches a month, no. I had 2 inches in 5 months.
The active ingredient in Monistat is meconazole nitrate. Woo, I said it right, I think. For the sake of pronunciation, I will refer to it as MN. MN treats infections caused by fungus, such as athlete's foot, ringworm, yeast infections, and jock itch. Those who are applying it to their scalp are claiming that it creates longer and faster hair growth, as well as regrowth from hair loss. The side effects are hair loss, that's redundant, dry hair, itching, burning, headaches, and even as bad as migraines. Dr. Mohsen Mir says that MN may reduce the hair loss receptors in the scalp. In this connection, this would consequently promote hair growth. In my research, I could not find any doctors that would admit to any products that could increase the growth phase or speed of hair. Dr. Adriana Jackson says there is no way to increase the hair growth cycle. This is a common misconception. The American Hair Loss Association says that 99% of hair loss remedies just don't work.
10.5. Month's time, average growth is 0.5. So my conclusion for myself is that meconazole nitrate does not work for me.
Hi everyone, I made this video because someone made a comment that the pictures aren't really my husband, that I went somewhere and I found these pictures. So basically I wanted to let you guys know that these are really true pictures. Monistat 7 can actually make your hair grow back. And yes, that is my husband.
So for the four methods that I've mentioned, I could not find any positive results outside of normal hair growth who had believable, detailed, accurate measurements with a ruler and specific dates. If you have found any, feel free to send me the links to the video. So my assessment after 15 years of experience doing hair and weighing the facts and evidence, I have concluded two things. Number one, everyone's hair cycle and texture is not created equal. Like with this hair crush obsession, so you're seeing, you know, these YouTubers and Instagrammers who have like beautiful, full, long hair, and you're using that as your goal that you're trying to get to, but you can't use someone else's hair as your goal. Like Natural 85, she got some beautiful hair, but I have to accept that I will never have hair like hers. I have accepted what my hair can and cannot do. So I'm always preaching to my clients and others that you have to have a healthy perspective about the hair that you grow from your own scalp. And what will help you have a healthy perspective is being content and embracing what your hair is capable of doing. Not what anybody else's looks like or what you wish your hair can do. If you just embrace what your hair can do, you'll feel so much better about your hair. And that's what looks beautiful, is confidence, rocking what you got. Number two would be, I believe that there were those who were able to promote healthier hair growth by using MN to correct scalp conditions such as balding and thinning, as well as to clear up fungal infections and follicle clogging dandruff, as well as incorporating vitamins for stronger, healthier hair. Which brings us to true or false. Everyone can grow long hair because no one was able to successfully prove to me that they were able to grow their hair longer or faster than what their hair is actually capable of doing, determined by their genes. I will have to say my answer is false. Everyone cannot grow long hair. If genetics weren't what governed our hair growth potential, female and male pattern baldness would be wiped out from the earth. Body hair, eyebrows, and eyelashes, they would never stop growing. And everyone would be capable of growing hair past their butts. I believe marketing companies are responsible for selling us these false hopes, capitalizing off our ignorance and insecurities. I believe there is no magic pill, serum, oil, or method that can actually grow our hair longer than what is predetermined by our genetics. Quick fixes are always too good to be true. There's always some type of side effect, and most of the time they don't even work. They're just placebos. We think they work. We pretend they work. Which brings me to talk about these common myths for hair growth that I hear on a regular basis from my clients or just random people. But just like I tell my clients, now I would like to publicly say, cutting your hair does not make it grow. It only prevents splitting and breaking to promote healthy hair growth. Braids, they don't make the hair grow faster. I promise you. Jerry curls don't make the hair grow faster or longer. Nothing makes the hair grow faster. They're all gimmicks. If you would like to challenge me on this, you're more than welcome to. But you have to use accurate measurements and accurate dates and clear pictures. Because I'm interested in knowing if there is something out there that can actually grow the hair longer and faster than what is predetermined by your genetics. I'm open to it. I tell my clients, if they're curious to how long their hair can grow in its healthiest state, take a look at your child pictures before you started using excessive heat and chemicals. That's a good way to determine how long your hair can actually grow. This is me as a child. As you can see, as of today, my hair looks around that length. My hair has never grown any longer than that. This is the first time in my adult life that I've actually let my hair grow this long. My hair cycle grows at a rate of about a half an inch a month for about 2.5 years. So my growth potential is about 14 to 15 inches. That's what I've been staying around. If you're interested in knowing more about my hair growth journey, I did create a video previously, and I'll post the link below this video. So before my research, I actually was going to test Hairfinity, but after everything that I've learned, I'm not willing to take the risk. So in my research, I actually found a lot of great information on superfoods that promote healthy hair growth and healthy skin, which actually produce better results than hair vitamins. I have been including a superfood in my diet for some months now, and a lot of people have been commenting on my skin. I will talk about what food this is and many others, as well as how malnutrition affects our hair growth in part 5 of this series. I want to give a big shout out to all my subscribers. Thanks y'all for the love. And to show my appreciation, I'm holding a continual monthly contest for y'all. Details are at the end of this video. I would love to hear from y'all if you found this helpful or if you have any questions or suggestions. I posted all my references and resources below this video too if you're interested in learning more about everything that I mentioned in this subject. The link for part 2 is also posted below so that you can learn the 2 things that your hair actually needs to promote healthy hair growth. Thanks for watching guys, and have a wonderful and blessed day, and remember to practice safe styling. Becoming Beauty Salon would like to show appreciation with this wonderful opportunity to win the following prizes every first of the month. You can click the link below this video for details.